The sea is a vast, unexplored area. There are over 200,000 species of sea creatures known to mankind. Of those, 1,200 are sharks and rays. One third of them have been threatened with extinction, with over 76 species of sharks and rays classified as critically endangered. As of now, there are 10 species of sharks and rays protected under Malaysia's Fisheries Act. But before we tell you what those 10 species are, let us introduce ourselves. Hello everyone, my name is Serena Adam. I work with the World Wide Fund for Nature Malaysia, also known as WWF Malaysia. My job is addressing bycatch of sharks and rays in small-scale fisheries, such as the kind of fishing that villagers do in small boats.
And I am Kooi Chee Ho. I work with the Marine Research Foundation. Similar to Serena, my job is also to address the accidental capture of sharks and rays. But my focus is on larger commercial fisheries. But we will get into that a little bit later.
So, as I was saying, in our country, there are only 10 species of sharks and rays protected under the Fisheries Act. They are the whale shark, smooth hammerhead shark, great hammerhead shark, oceanic white-tip shark, winged shark, reef manta, giant oceanic manta, large-toothed sawfish, green sawfish, and narrow sawfish. We need to protect both our sharks and rays as they play multiple key roles in ocean ecosystems, making them intertwined with the health of our ocean and the people who depend on them. For instance, oceanic sharks and rays, such as the basking shark and manta rays, are known to be mixers of the blue, as they help to mix ocean layers as they carry out vertical migrations throughout the day, moving in a yo-yo-like pattern through the water column. This movement helps bring nutrients for microscopic plants called phytoplankton to grow. These phytoplankton are the base of all ocean food webs. This is very significant, as phytoplankton are also responsible for producing up to 50% of the oxygen we breathe. Aside from that, bottom-dwelling rays such as stingrays and whiptail rays act as habitat engineers, thanks to their unique way of feeding. As they excavate the sand in search of food, they simultaneously create microhabitat for other marine species to feed, such as small reef fishes to bigger predatory jacks. Overfishing is by far the greatest threat for sharks and rays. Their numbers have drastically declined over the last half a century. In Malaysia, sharks and rays are known to be caught as bycatch, which means they are accidentally caught in fishing nets that normally catch other species. There are three major types of fishing gear that contribute to bycatch in Malaysia, of which 60% are trawls, 30% are gill nets, and 10% are long lines. Fishers in our country usually sell everything they catch, including our sharks and rays. This is because there are still people who consume them as food. Even though sharks and rays are caught as bycatch, it is important that we address this problem to prevent driving these species further to extinction. Luckily, Casey and I are doing just that, so let's show you what we do. With the help of two fishers from Tun Mustafa Park, I am investigating if light-emitting diodes, or LEDs, in gill nets could reduce bycatch of sharks and rays. The study has shown that the nets with lights catch fewer sharks and rays compared to the ones without lights. This proves that this method could reduce bycatch. Our team at WWF Malaysia are also monitoring species underwater by deploying baited remote underwater video cameras, also known as RUF. They are placed in different locations and left for an average of 60 to 90 minutes for the camera to capture imagery of any underwater visitors. Footage of sharks and rays enables me to study their journeys in detail and effectively identify their hotspots. This could tell us where fishing activities should not be allowed.
The key to address bycatch in commercial fisheries is by finding out the key areas where bycatch occurs. As a marine conservation officer with MRF, we have made an agreement with some of our local fishermen to jointly reduce bycatch. With that agreement, the fishermen have agreed to install cameras on fishing trawlers. The camera captures images every 5 seconds, and the images reveal the boat's trajectory and the time, as well as GPS coordinates of when bycatch events occur, which helps to identify the bycatch hotspots. The camera is powered by a 12-volt battery and charged by a solar panel so it can last for 1 to 2 weeks. Currently, we have 35 cameras, of which 24 cameras are running at any point in time across 5 districts in Sabah, namely Kota Kinabalu, Sempona, Kudat, Tawau, and Sandakan, so that it is easier for researchers to identify important areas for certain species, such as where they reproduce or where they aggregate during certain times of the year.
Fishers in Malaysia are stewards of the ocean. Therefore, maintaining an open channel of communication and collaboration with them is key for conserving sharks and rays. Moreover, working collectively with government agencies, coastal communities, the private sector, and the public is also important. On that account, we as Malaysians can also help by sharing and spreading information related to sharks and rays among each other and educating ourselves more on their importance to ocean ecosystems. Preventing extinction is key. Therefore, by starting our move now, we can assure that the next generation can continue to enjoy the beauty and the diversity of sharks and rays in Malaysia, especially for the future generation of Sabahans. If you stop eating sharks and rays, fishes will release most of them back into the sea and will work towards ensuring endangered sharks and rays don't end up in our nets in the future.
Thank you.